Good morning, my friends. It's so good to be back with you this morning, getting ready to do another post for the vicarage. Just some quick updates. Today is a pretty quiet day. I'm finally going to get that reading day. I do have to go to the hospital for one visitation this afternoon, and so Pastor Dan and I are going to do that after lunch. Pretty much it is a day where we can catch up, and I can get a lot of the reading and writing done that I need to do. We had a great prayer meeting this morning, and today is my daughter's first wedding rehearsal where she is leading the wedding rehearsal. I'm going along just for a comfort factor, but she is doing her first wedding ever this weekend, so that's pretty exciting. And so we're doing the wedding rehearsal, and then we're going out shopping for her pastor's attire for the wedding. So that should be a lot of fun today. I guess what I wanted to go back to really quickly and just very briefly, I felt like yesterday as I was talking about the wound beneath the armor, maybe I was getting a little ahead of myself. I want to make sure people understand what I'm talking about when I speak about spiritual warfare. When we use the word warfare, particularly in our current context in the world, where everything is so crazy and there's so much actual war going on, physical war going on, where people are taking guns to each other, and there's so many battles across the face of our world, there's a mistake in thinking that Christianity is when we use the word spiritual warfare, we're talking about physical violence and rising up physically, and that's not what we're talking about at all. Ephesians chapter 6 uses these words: "We do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers of this present darkness, against rulers and authorities in spiritual places." Spiritual warfare is talking about the battle that goes on underneath the surface of this world at all times. It's a spiritual warfare, not a warfare of the flesh, not doesn't use weapons like guns or knives or fists or anger or malice or rage or any of those things. The warfare that we're called to as Christians is not a warfare in the physical. In fact, we're told we do not fight against other people, against flesh and blood, but against powerful spiritual forces that have taken over our world. C.S. Lewis said that as Christians, we often fall into one of two camps, two extremes. We either pay too much attention to the devil, or we don't pay any attention to him at all. Spiritual warfare calls us to recognize that we do have an enemy, and he is the devil, and he is our real enemy, and we must fight against him. On the other hand, we also have to recognize that while we have an enemy, the devil, we can't pay him too much mind. Our job is to bring Jesus into the situation so he can fight our battles for us. That's what spiritual warfare is. It's not so much focusing on the devil or rebuking the devil or any of that. It's about bringing Jesus into the world so he can undo the works of the devil. And we do that by using the fruit of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, patience, gentleness, kindness, faith, meekness, goodness, and self-control. And we also do that by putting on the armor of God: truth, righteousness, peace, knowledge of salvation, faith, and the Word of God. And those are the things that we fight with as Christians. We bring Jesus into every situation with us, and by that, we undo the works of the devil. Our goal is never to win the upper hand. Our goal is always to build the kingdom. And if we have to take a lower seat or even step back for a moment in order for the kingdom to be built, we're willing to do that because that's the nature of spiritual warfare. It doesn't seek to come out ahead. It seeks to follow God's will and to release God into the world. And that's a servant's heart. Well, I leave you with these thoughts, and if you have questions about spiritual warfare and how we are as Christians to fight, we'll be talking more about it in the future, but you can also drop me a line here. Have a great day.